Well, could you describe the museum event? What happened?
You mean what happened at the robbery?
Yeah.
13 years ago, St. Patty's Day Eve.
On St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah, are you from Emerson? Where are you from?
Emerson.
Are you from Emerson College? Or from...
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, seriously.
Yeah, seriously. That's our production company. So was there a robbery?
Zach Crayley.
That's
right. Hello, Zach.
Hi there.
What's your name?
I'm Frank.
Frank. Right. So what happened?
13 years ago.
On St. Patrick's
Day. To Vermeer.
What was their worth?
I've got no highlight on. I've got nothing on. Not bad for 60, huh, guys? It's a $500 million now, an estimate. They were...
Did they find them?
They were... No. You see, this is an ongoing FBI investigation. They were two Vermeer, Rubens, Rembrandt, and very, very... Four Degas, very expensive altogether. Nine masterpieces.
Yeah, it's from National Underground, Thunderbounds when I stomp the ground. Like a million elephants, a silverback orangutan. You can't stop a train. Who wants up? Don't come unprepared. I'll leave there, but when I leave there, better be a household name. Weatherman telling us it ain't gonna rain. So now we sitting in a drop top soaking wet. In a silk suit, try not to sweat. Hit somersaults without the net. But this be the year that we won't forget. 1999. And I don't need anything gold. Be what you wanna be. Long as you know consequences are given for living defenses. Too hot to jump in jail. Too low to dig, I might just touch hell. Hot, get a life, now they gon' sell. Then I might catch you a spell. Look at what came in the mail. A scale and some arm and hammer. So bro grillin' a baby mama. Black hair lacking a back of pebbles. Stack of questions with no answers. Cure for cancer, cure for AIDS. Make a nigga wanna stay on tour for days. Get back home, things are wrong. When not really, it was bad all along. Before you left ass up to a ball of power. Thoughts at 1,000 miles per hour. Hello ghetto, let your...
I tried. Just try with no clothes on.
Quite often when I'm walking down the street in downtown Boston, large men run into me and then they say, "Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Excuse me, please move." And then it just gave me attitude and actually did a hip. And he should just train them die. That's like saying that I'm really short and, you know, I'm 5 feet. My name is Aniraya Flores. I gave birth to a baby squirrel and then I shot it in the face.
They came dressed as policemen at 12:30 at night, rang the doorbell, completely, authentically Boston policemen. They said they needed to use the phone. It was just before cell phones, so they could get away with saying that they really needed to use the phone while the cruising car radio was broken.
Uh-huh.
Security is literally, at that point, guards caught off guard.
Uh-huh.
You see?
So,
I've seen you there, Zach.
Have you?
Haven't to the gardener?
Yes.
See, Mrs. Gardner, it's a Venetian palazzo. You guys ought to go. It's a Venetian palazzo.
Uh-huh.
She brought back piece by piece from Italy.
Uh-huh.
And it is phenomenal. It's a Venetian palazzo, the paintings, the furniture, from medieval to Renaissance, high Renaissance. And
so
the courtyard, of course, is authentic. She brought it back from Venice by ship.
Italy?
From Venice.
Florence.
Her courtyard.
That's in Florence, right?
Italy.
Right, Florence.
Well, like, she had a palace in Venice. She brought the courtyard from Venice back.
And that's in Florence.
Well, Florence is in Italy.
And Venice is in Florence, right?
No, Venice is in Italy also. Florence and Venice and Rome and Milano, they're all like in America.
Is it like how Boston is in Massachusetts?
Exactly.
Venice is in Florence.
Venice is in Italy.
Okay.
Florence is in Italy.
So
Venice
is in Italy. So it's like Massachusetts.
Rome is in Italy. Is he joshing me?
So you're it's like Massachusetts here? And Connecticut.
Right.
Venice is Connecticut and Florence is Connecticut.
No, Venice, Italy.
Right.
And she brought from her Venetian palace in Italy.
What's that
by ship, because Mr. Gardner one-third of the Titanic lines by ship. He's joshing me, isn't he? This is an entire...
No,
you are. You're good at it, though. You're good at ad-libbing. It was really one of the worst art heists ever. I said 13 years ago,
so
St. Patty's
Day. St. Patty's Day.
They tied the guards up immediately. They bound and gagged them.
No
put them down
activities.
The basement.
No.
And this is... you're a comedy channel, right?
Yeah.
This is not a comedy. It was horrible.
Did people die?
No.
That's not horrible enough.
No. We just cut them very carefully out of the frames like this.
Hitler, that was horrible.
Totally.
This is like a day in the park.
Yes, it was. A day in Venice.
People get bound and gagged in the Common all the time. You ever been there?
Of course I've been there.
I can't keep a straight face. All right, thanks, Frank.
Oh, we'll you're welcome.
To stop by. Do you
anyway,
work there?
You guys are great.
Do you work there?
I can't go on any further about it.
Okay.
Look for me on Court TV. There is one interview and biography called Stolen. We filmed it at the Copley Plaza Hotel.
Okay.
You know, because of my 50 years.
We got kicked out.
You were?
Yeah, we were doing interviews that kicked us out.
Oh, well. You're better off to do it over here.
Yeah.
You know, ad lib. And
yeah.
You guys will be stars. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks.
All right.
Thanks, Frank.
That's right down the road there.
Yeah.
Crossing Fine Arts. Have you heard of the recent robbery? What happened was it happened like 13 years ago?
Well, that robbery, I know.
Right.
The fella who may have stolen the first time was someone who lived in my house.
He lived in your house?
Possibly.
Whoa. How did you figure that out?
It was a fella who was a UMass student, uh-huh. And he lived in my house for a certain period of time, stole some things from me, didn't pay any rent,
uh-huh.
And then... moved out to California and tried to sell a screenplay about a robbery, just like The Gardener.
Oh.
And
did he move out like right after the robbery?
Yes.
Wow.
He was a suspect for the robbery.
Is he still a suspect?
I think so.
What's his name?
I had a number of robot toys as a child. Then along came 2XL. He changed my life. And he had a friend named Grubby. So I kept putting them off and putting them off, thinking like, then putting them off. No, I had no idea that I was gay when I was a kid. And I'm Jackie Liebergott's illegitimate stepchild. My name is Jeremiah Koick, and I'm an actual Apple switcher.
Back to that same old thing. Sweet home Boston. Come on, baby, don't you wanna go?
This has been a
Yar Matey
production.
It's way off.
You don't say production.
Oh, I say production?
Yes.
You guys should have told me
all
that.
We say is Yar Matey.
Okay.
Oh.